And I do think that this deal represents a very good deal, both for the EU and for the UK. And it's a reasonable, fair outcome and reflects the large amount of work that's been undertaken by both sides. And I agree very much, Jean-Claude, with what you said about protecting the peace process in the island of Ireland and in Northern Ireland. And, of course, for us in the UK, it means that we can deliver a real Brexit that achieves our objectives. And it means that the UK leaves whole and entire on October the 31st. And it means that Northern Ireland and every other part of the UK can take part not just in free trade deals, offering our tariffs, exporting our goods around the world, but it also means that we can take together as a single, a united kingdom, decisions about our future, about our laws, our borders, our money, and how we want to run the UK. And those decisions will be taken in the UK by elected representatives of the people of the UK. And I hope very much now, speaking of elected representatives, that my fellow MPs in Westminster do now come together to get Brexit done, to get this excellent deal over the line, and to deliver Brexit without any more delay, so that we can focus on the priorities of the British people, improving our health service, investing in 20,000 more police, lifting up the living wage, and many, many other things. And Jean-Claude, I just want to conclude by agreeing wholeheartedly with your final point. Now is the moment for us to get Brexit done and then together to work on building our future partnership, which I think can be incredibly positive, both for the UK and for the EU. And I just remind you what I always say, that we are a quintessential European country, solid European friends, neighbours and supporters. And we look forward to working with you in building that partnership in the weeks and months to come. Thank you all very much.